Thank you. My name is Ankur Ghosh. I am a senior manager at Cleantech Solar, and incidentally, I was one of the first employees when we started off in India in 2015. Since then, we've grown exponentially, and as you may know, we were acquired by Shell last year. So I'll just take you through what we do. I won't take a lot of your time because as far as I can see, this room is full of people we already work with, so I won't bore you with a lot of specifics, but I'll just give you an overview. We are based out of Singapore, HQ Singapore, and we work in 8 geographies. I'll take you through them one by one. And the reason that we do this is because of our tagline, which is trusted by corporations. So my whole point, the whole point of this presentation is to convey to you why we're trusted by corporations. First and foremost, we are primarily a C&I rooftop developer. Most of our portfolio is on the rooftop, like I've said before. We do custom solutions, asterisks with a custom, because I'll tell you why there's an asterisk there. But we do custom solutions for MNCs and blue chip companies all over Southeast Asia. This is one of our marquee plants. It's right next to HQ in Singapore. You can see it's got a carport, an RCC, and a world-class marquee shed project in one single location. It is a trendsetter as far as the Singapore market is concerned, because now the new regulations that's come in takes this as the example plant for that regulation. This is another one of our custom solutions. This is in Cambodia. This is floating solar. We were one of the pioneers in Cambodia, and I think one of the first 10 in the world to get this going. Right? These are the locations we are at. We work primarily out of India. This is where we started, and this is where most of our portfolio is. We also have Vietnam, Philippines, Cambodia, Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia. Thailand is this next emerging market that we see after India. We do a lot of work in Thailand, and basically Thailand is controlled from Singapore, but it's got its own team like we have in India. Right. So our portfolio is the largest in Southeast Asia. It's 400 megawatts, of which approximately 300 is just rooftops, and 100 are group captive projects in India. We have over 200 solar sites and 100 customers, more than 100 customers. Right? And our institutional backers are basically Shell. They own 49%, and a Swiss asset management fund called CFM. Our lenders are Tata Cleantech Capital, SBI World Bank, and a few others. I'll take you through them also. So this is what our story looks like. 2015 isn't here, but 2015 we were probably number 6 or something. And since then we've been coming up consistently. For the past 3 quarters at least, we've been number 1. This is the latest one. This is the BTI report. I think we all refer to this one for India. Right. So as I said, most of our solutions are on the rooftop, but we are now very much into the C&I group captive market. To give you some numbers, we have 110 megawatts already commissioned. We are now the leaders in the group captive solution in India. And we have approximately 700 megawatts that will be commissioned by December 2020. Our states are the ones that we concentrated on: Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Haryana, Rajasthan, UP and MP. These are investors. Like I said, you know, we're trusted by corporations, and the reason that it's like that is because we've got a long-term mindset. Our plants across Southeast Asia are exactly the same as far as the specifications go. We only use BNEF Tier 1 modules. We only have 5 inverter companies we work with. We only have 4 EPCs that we work with. Everything is chosen. Everything is bankable and approved by lenders. So you won't see many deviations in our portfolio. Completely standardized plants. Moreover, you know, the kind of data that we give to our lenders, to our investors, is world class. Like I was saying during the panel discussion before, that it probably is up to us to share the data that we have with the government, with the policymakers, and with the fraternity, with the solar fraternity, and with the bodies that that run the solar field in our country, to basically help. For example, you know, people talk about string level monitoring. We even do cell level monitoring. All our plants have a biannual drone inspection that takes thermal photographs of each and every panel, and we figure out if there's a crack or a micro crack in any panel. So we go to that level of detail, and this is something that is driven not by a whim. This is driven by investors such as Shell, such as Climate Fund, and the European Union funders. So that's the reason that corporations decide to go with us. Our Pan-Asia portfolio helps them to basically, you know, use us in one go. If Cambodia and Coca-Cola signs us up, we automatically have an inroads to Coca-Cola in India. Similarly, Thailand, Vietnam, it all falls into place. There's a synergy that happens. We don't have to go through their vendor selection process. Billing is completely automized because we're doing it in one place. It's all central billing. So it works out to our favor. This is a sample list of our customers. As you can see, we've got pretty much the entire gamut in India and abroad. Everything from auto OEMs to textile, automation, tire industries. We've got FMCG, steel, and also people like Hinware and Franke who make appliances for homes. So we've got the entire gamut, and I hope we'll add a lot more. This is just a sample list, but I hope we'll get a lot more diversified as we go further. One of the other reasons that MNCs and companies as such trust us is because we gel our values with theirs. So the first and foremost thing, besides the whole point of it being centrally controlled and the whole point of having Pan-Asia presence is, our values match. And one of the big things for everybody now is safety, right? So our plants from day one have had walkways, lifeline handrails from 2015 onwards. Like, this is something that we do. Even if the customer says we don't want it, we do it. Our O&M team demands it. And these are all, you know, tier one suppliers. We have our own requirements as far as those go too. There are roofs that we cannot install on. For example, you know, there are some roofs that others will say they will install us. We do a prelim survey. We take our structural consultant there and we get a structural stability certificate and we've rejected roofs. So that's just to stress that something like safety is something that flows all the way from the top and comes to the bottom, all the way to execution. You know, even though we're not an EPC, that's by design. We understand that, you know, we could make margins as an EPC by including it in our offering, but we don't do it because we feel that that would be a conflict of interest as far as safety is concerned. So we've got our own owner's engineer project slash project management team. I was a part of that team earlier. So some things that we do for safety is, for example, we've got our own on-site training. So this is done in the regional language of the area. So if you're doing a project in Maharashtra, the audio for that video will be in Marathi, whereas the written part would be in English. Then we would give them a survey that would say, okay, have you actually understood what you've learned? No matter how many times we've worked with these people, we will still get it done as a part of a compliance checklist. So that's one of the reasons the customers love it too. You know, it enforces the whole safety thing, and it honestly gives us very good results. If you guys want to know more about that, I had a part to play in getting that done, and I'd be happy to share it with you. Similarly, you know, we've got all the documentation and all the procedures on lockdown. These standards that you see here, like those documents you see, those are the same for Singapore as they are in India. Now, you might say, how do those compliances gel? Well, they don't. We go above and beyond in India to make sure that we reach the Singapore standards even here. This is also one of the reasons that our long-term mindset exists. It's because of the kind of board members we have. This is the founding members. The first four are the founding members. Raju Shukla, he was heading Barclays in India before retirement. And before that, he was also taking care of Deutsche Bank and the Warburg Pincus Group in India. After that is Robert Morris. He was taking care of Barclays in Asia. He was taking care of all of Asia. And Dr. Eek, he still heads our risk management team, which is an integral part of what we do. It's an integral part of our customer selection process. And right now, he is a board member at Cleantech and also heads Valesco Capital, which is an Austrian private equity firm. The last two, Michael and Boris, they came in after Shell took us over last December. And they also have extensive backgrounds in the energy sector. Having done it, I think combined experience would be around 4 decades, I would say, for just the last two. This is our regional management team. They all sit in Singapore. Jerome is a chief of operations. He's the guy who actually monitors everyday site work, everyday issues with Cleantech. Alan is a head of EPC. I think a lot of you already know him. He comes to Hyderabad to our engineering office there a lot. I know a lot of you have interacted with him. So have you interacted with Raghav, who's our project management head, and Andre, Dr. Nobre, who heads our O&M. So a fun fact, every time you see or use PVSys reports and there is a simulation, credit goes, a part of the credit goes to him because he's the guy who wrote the paper on tropical climates and generations in tropical climates. So he knows what he's talking about. And whenever our investors have any questions, he's the guy they go to. He has all the data. He has the world-class SCADA systems that we install on every site. Even if it's a 250 kilowatt peak site, we'll have the same SCADA as we do on our 20 megawatt peak sites. the data inputs and everything. Like I said, custom asterisks, that's the asterisks. It's custom, yes, it could be floating, it could be on a rooftop, it could be on the ground. But the output, that is power and data, and the parameters of those two will remain the same regardless of where the site is. And he's the guy who basically spec'd that specification out for us and is centrally dispatched from Singapore. So the system itself, you might see, you know, if you go to a solar site with GSM-based SCADA, you'll see there's a router with a LAN cable coming in. None of that. We don't have a LAN cable coming in. Our thing is not a D-Link router. It's an industrial grade, military spec, drop tested and all that stuff, SCADA system that is truly world class. It's something we're very proud of. It's something that we understand the value of. And we also understand that many people don't, might say that it's not required everywhere. Well, when you have a portfolio with these many sites, it is required everywhere. An investor, when you're aggregating and securitizing this kind of a portfolio, will ask for it. So we highly recommend it too. This is the India management team. Dr. Joshi is who I report to. He's in Delhi. He has the BD team in India. Prashant is our head of finance and operations in Mumbai. Vikram comes from Renew. He is heading our open access efforts in Delhi as well. Mr. Venkatraman is from SunSource, used to work for SunSource. Now he's heading special projects in India, basically the large open scale, open access projects, sorry, group captive projects. Sridhara is in Hyderabad. If you need to get in touch regarding getting approved, getting your makes approved, he's the guy to talk to. I can connect you with him if you need to. Rupesh is our head of O&M. He is in Chennai. Right, and just as a last sampler, I'll just take you through a few more projects. That's a Tirunelveli project in Tamil Nadu, 150. That's Maharashtra. We've got three sites going on there in those locations. These are group captive locations. And that's our Apollo Tyres plant, and a lot more coming for Apollo Tyres in Tamil Nadu through that group captive plant. Right, we believe this is the largest single site rooftop project OPEX in the world. We have not been able to figure out if it's the world, but we know that in India it is. Single location, Arvind Mills. Right, Coca-Cola is one of those Southeast Asia synergies that we've been able to find. You know, we did Cambodia first and then Malaysia and India followed. And that's about it for me. I hope I didn't bore you guys too much, but please come to me. I'll be right outside if you guys want to get in touch with anybody you saw on that slide. Thank you.